Good morning here from Skoongezicht. Today we're going to take you through a very sad day in the history of Skoongezicht. Since we started Skoongezicht back in 2001, this is one of the days that I really regret happening ever to us. For those who have visited Skoongezicht before will know that we have a lot of rhino and we've been involved with rhino breeding and the conservation of rhino. For a lot of you that doesn't know us, wouldn't have known this because we tried to keep it a secret as long as possible. But after two very bad incidents of poaching on Skoongezicht, we took the very sad but necessary decision to start dehorning our precious animals. For us, it's really sad that this needs to be done, and we're going to take you through the day and see what's happening on the ground. Today in South Africa there's a huge onslaught on rhinos, especially on private ownership. Today I'm going to take you through this whole process of dehorning the rhinos. But before I do that, I really want you that's sitting there behind the keyboard, sometimes criticizing us as game farmers, to take a good look on what's happening on the ground. I want to thank everybody that's involved, some of my friends and partners who believed in this rhino project from the start to try and make a difference. But for you that's an anti-hunter, anti-trading of rhino horn, I hope you will see what you've done to our industry. We as game farmers today has more than 50% of the rhinos still alive in Africa belongs to private owners. With no subsidies, no help, but only criticism sometimes from anti-hunters and people that's against the rhino trade. I truly believe that the only way we can conserve the rhino is to give the value back to the farmer or the owner of the rhino. Today everybody is making money out of rhino. Even the poacher, the guy that's selling a bumper sticker, the guy that's selling a t-shirt, everybody is making money out of it, except the farmer that owns a rhino, because we love them. We tried our best from the start to try and conserve these animals, and today is D-Day. Luckily for us, we can conserve them, although we need to take off the horn. So you that's sitting there in New York or anywhere in the world that's criticizing us, hopefully today you and the poacher, you're in the same class. So I hope you will see what you're doing to our precious animals. Thank you very much. Doesn't know this, every rhino in the middle of his horn has got a little heart, maybe telling us as manhood what we've done with these animals. It's really sad, but yeah, in the middle of the horn there's a small heart, and yeah, our hearts also go out for these animals of what we're trying to accomplish. You will see us a lot of people today involved in the operation, all vehicles, and the vet, Dr. Louis Grief. Nature Conservation is here, Nampi, you're a legend around here, all our workers. The family is also here, but yeah. This is the last rhino. Ons skoon gesig, that had a horn. Sad day for us, but unfortunately, need to be done. And also putting on a collar on each animal to track them a little bit better. Because for us, it's also important that they roam a bit more freely than in small areas. So, yeah, let's see. After two very bad incidents, if this is going to be the answer.
Hi. Myself. 7-8 line.
And yeah, that's the reason why we dehorned. But just to give you an indication, this calf mother was killed, and as you see previously, the calf always stays with the mother, so they shot the calf as well. Luckily, the calf survived it. Dr. Greef, it's the second time he's treated this calf now, and we'll hope we'll survive. But yeah, for us, it's absolutely terrible and see what's happening to these animals. I said this was the calf of the mother that died. Luckily, he's weaned, so he will survive. But yeah, he's really struggling at this stage. But Dr. Louis is treating him very, very well, and he's actually recovering very well.
They shot him here in the front leg. Luckily, no damage his radial nerve, but the bullet is lodged here in the radius. We tried to retrieve it, but it's stuck there. The wound is draining well, and the calf would survive. It's not as sore and as swollen as we saw him the first time. The wound's actually looking good. But it's sad that they are messing around with these animals, and we must all stand together and ask for better and bigger action against this cruelty. Because these animals are actually very special animals. Why is some of our heritage? We must protect it at all costs. Makes Africa, and it makes South Africa even more special than any other country, because there's no other country that has the amount of white rhinos that we have. It makes us special, and we must protect it.
And currently, I think what is also interesting to know is that more than half of the rhinos still alive in South Africa is belonging to private owners. And yeah, we don't always want to talk about the cost and everything involved in keeping rhinos, but you know, nobody's helping the private rhino owners in any way to do what we do every day on the veld. You know, Dr. Louis, Dolph, everybody involved here, they're trying their best to do stuff like this. But for us as rhino owners, this is absolutely terrible. And the only reason I have rhinos is because we're in a safe area. We thought we can protect them. But yeah, currently we have lost the battle. For me, it's a sad day. You know, we always looked after the animals every single day. We feed them. All my workers is always under threat. If there's something happening to them at night, everybody goes out. But yeah, very sad. We can't keep them safe anymore. So we're trying the next thing and to take off the horns. But yeah, hopefully this calf will survive. We're calling him Survivor, and we'll keep you posted how Survivor is doing. Thank you, Dr. Louis.
George. Hi.
Okay, just waiting. I'm standing here with Dolph. He's the pilot of relatively a sad day for me. We're doing the deorning of all the rhinos here on Skoongezicht. Yeah, Dolph, you work with this every day. You're the pilot. You're also part of a project that really tried to make a difference. And yeah, just tell us a little bit more what you're doing around.
Yes, George. It's not nice to do this, but unfortunately, we need to do it. We need to deal on animals. Yeah, we tried to set the rhinos to deorn them and to put on a collaring system so then we can track them. Unfortunately, that's the only way for us to know if they're still alive and for a farmer to know if they're alive. So it's not nice. We don't like to do it, but at this stage it's only.
Yeah, look, Dolph, we had the rhinos now for close to 10 years. And, you know, this was our second incident. So we also took a very, very difficult decision to dehorn the rhino. All of our rhinos went. So for us, it's a very sad day. But yeah, thanks for all your help and what you guys are trying to accomplish and all the hard work. You know, there's a lot of people sitting around with a lot of things to say about rhino, but nobody's really on the ground like the farmers and people like you that's flying every day and just doing this. So
yeah, it's like I said, you know, it's it costs a lot of money to do this, unfortunately. So but yeah, but we try to keep the helicopter in the air and the vets darting, and I think that's the only way we can save our runners.
Thank you, Dolph. Peter, Wouter, Dolph, while the last rhino that we deorned is waking up there in the background. Peter is one of my good friends. He's also a game farmer. But Peter, you guys are really trying to make a difference. You're from Matlabas. That's it's a non-profit organization in our farming area that not just trying to conserve the rhinos but try to keep our area safe. So Peter from Skoongezicht site, thank you very, very much for that. But please, Peter, you're also involved with the collaring of the animals. So just tell us a little bit more about the collar of the animal. On the leg, there we can see the animal is now got a collar on her leg.
Yeah, and it's, you know, solar powered. So the animal gets monitored. You know, if something happens to the animal, there's immediately alert that goes off. And that way, we hope that we can be a bit more proactive, you know, in catching these people that, you know, is you know, the reason why this all is, we're doing this, you know, the poachers.
Yeah. So there's an alarm system going off on our cell phones, and yeah, then we call out the Matlabas guys. Both of you also very involved in that. Thank you very much for that. And yeah, let's see if this is going to change of what we're doing, trying to conserve the rhinos. Thank you, guys.
You're welcome, George. And it's definitely a step in the right direction. You know, time will tell what you will see.